Hi everyone, in this video clip we are going to be performing post-installation configuration tasks on server 2016. First I'm going to log in with the administrator account. I'm going to choose no for this PC being discoverable on networks. The reason I'm going to do that is because later I can show you how to change firewall profiles if you need to. And I'll just give our server manager a minute here to come up and initialize. Okay, here's our server manager utility. I'm going to select local server so that we can perform the configuration functions or tasks on this particular server. You'll notice at the top of the properties, there's a number of other pieces of information lower than that. Not going to worry about those right now. We'll come back up to the top and work on this functionality. Once all of the information has been enumerated, this unknown listings will disappear and we'll see information that's actually pertinent to this particular server. Okay, one of the first things we want to do is we're going to change time zone. Time zone isn't going to be super important for this lab, but it is when you get into things like Active Directory services, that type of a thing. Just going to scroll over here a bit to the right. Here is our time zone. We select that and the link will bring up the control panel for date and time like you would normally use if you're going to change the time. I'll click on change the time zone, select Eastern time. In my case, say okay to that and okay, and our time zone is now changed. Some other things we're going to modify. Mentioned before that firewall, we may have to change the zone for that or the profile, and I'll show you why. One of the things we always want to set up on a server is the ability for remote desktop, unless your security profile prevents you from doing that. Really easy to do. Click on the remote desktop link. It brings up system properties. I'm going to say I want to allow connections to this computer. Say OK so that it changes the firewall rules to allow the protocol through. And I'll say OK, and that's all we need to do. It's all great, except that one of the things we run into is if you're in the public firewall profile, it will not let the remote desktop protocol through. In order to change that, we can't simply go and click on something. We need PowerShell for that. So let me show you how that works. I'm going to launch PowerShell. Once the menu system comes up, we'll see that PowerShell is actually going to be an option for us. So I'll select this and then launch PowerShell. Now what we want to do is look at the information for a network connection profile and change that. The commandlet is get net connection profile. So I just did get netcon, hit tab, it'll auto-complete. And once that completes, we just hit enter. And we'll see the results of this is going to be the profile for one network connection because we only have one network adapter. That's this one here. We can identify this adapter either by name, interface alias, or interface index when we want to make changes to it. The main thing we want to change is the network category, which is now public. We want that to become private. The way we do that is with the set net connection profile commandlet. I have to tell it what network connection to work on. I'll just say in this case, name is network. And then the property we want to change is network category. And we want to change that to private. So execute that commandlet. If I go back and get the net connection profile now, we'll see that this is private rather than public. And if I update in Server Manager and refresh, we'll see that this is going to change from public to private. What that means is in the future, if somebody tries to connect with remote desktop, the firewall will allow the protocol through. Another thing that we need to change is IP. Right now, IP is assigned manually, or automatically with DHCP. Servers very often have, in fact, most of the time, have manual addresses or statically assigned addresses. Just have to click on the link, and that will bring up the control panel that allows us to modify network connections. Notice that this does not have a very meaningful name. Good practice is to change that. I'm going to rename the network connection from Ethernet 0 to production. It's going to be connected to our production network. And now I'll go into the properties for the connection to change IP. So we're going to change IPv4. I'm going to set this manually. And in this case, we're using /27 for our address. That is our default gateway. And that is our DNS server. We will OK out of that to make the changes. If I bring my PowerShell window back up again, we can now use the IP config command to make sure that those changes are configured the way we want them to be. And we can see the appropriate IP address, subnet mask, default gateway that was set a second ago. We want to do a quick test on that. Do a quick ping with Google to Google's website, and we can see successful response. So that's all good. A couple of other small things that we have to do. Since this is a virtual machine running in a VMware environment, we should install VMware Tools. So I can click on the link for that down at the bottom and then get rid of that warning since I don't really care about that anymore. It will mount the image for VMware Tools, and in a second we'll see a pop-up come up to tell us that we can start working on that. Okay, not sure why I didn't get a pop-up there, but I'll open our file browser, and if I go to this PC, we'll see VMware Tools on the optical drive. I'll just open that. We can see that that is now launching. And once the install wizard comes up, we're just going to take all of the defaults and allow VMware Tools to install. So here's our wizard. Let's say next to launch that. Typical installation is fine. And I'll start the installation. Now in the meantime, another thing I'm going to do is we're going to want to change our computer name. Typically the computer name is going to match the VM name. And I'll change this while VMware Tools is installing. The reason I'm going to do that is both changing the name and VMware Tools installation requires a reboot, so I can kill both of these with one reboot. Go into change. The computer, the VM name is SV2016-01. I'll do the same thing for the computer name or the host name. Say OK to that. It will do a quick scan on the network to find out if there's any duplicate names. I'll say yes, that's all fine. I'll close this. It's going to prompt to restart. Before I do that, I want to do a check to find out where we are with VMware Tools. That's not finished installing yet, so I don't want to reboot. Nope, here we are. We're just finished. So I'll say finish that. So this is also prompting for a restart. I'll say go ahead and do that. It'll reboot, and once it comes back, we're finished with the post-installation config. Okay, this is rebooted. It's going to take up the screen space, log back in as administrator. And And there's one thing that I forgot before that we'll do now, and that is I want to change the firewall to allow ping traffic to hit this particular system. So once our server manager comes back up, we'll take care of that. All right, so server manager's back up. We can see the changes we made. Here's the static IP address, the change to our name for the host, that type of thing. Just going to click on Windows Firewall. That's going to bring up the firewall control panel. I'll click on Advanced Settings, and I'm going to modify an inbound rule to allow ICMPv4. The way we do that is scroll down to File and Print Sharing, which might sound a bit weird, but that's what it is. Very top option is ICMPv4 in. Just right-click, enable that rule, and we're now able to ping this particular host. And that is it for post-installation config. Hopefully this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.